kids playing in backyard having fun, and juxtapose that with a pile of trash and a hypodermic needle. Hey folks, yesterday I got a contact from one of the fans on the Community TV Facebook page, and they said that I should go check out a situation next to an apartment complex, and there was apparently a dumpster there that was completely overflowing, and a lot of the neighbors had been having problems with that, garbage blowing out of the open dumpster into their yards where their kids play, just garbage all down the alley. I guess this two apartment buildings are now using one dumpster where there used to be two, and it's just not working out. Residents there are obviously not having enough space to get rid of their waste, or the waste isn't being picked up quick enough. So I went up there to see what was going on and get a shot of the dumpster. Before I talked to anybody up there, just coincidentally, the guys from Avenue Living, a company who I've had encounters with in the past, pulled up, and this is what happened.
Fucking camera off.
No, you don't. You don't even know the whole story, buddy.
Tell me it.
No, you don't need to. Okay,
stop. Whoa, back up for me. No. Don't walk up on me, man.
Okay.
Wrong idea.
No.
Wrong idea, man. Don't walk up on me.
Don't do this.
Tell me the story or walk away.
Don't do this.
I do what I want.
Why? What's wrong with the bin?
People complaining about it. I came up here and the first thing is you walking up to me and swearing and hollering and stuff.
Sometimes you get into people's business you don't need to be in there, right?
Okay. What's your name?
You know me, Tom. I just drove you.
What's your name?
Get in the car.
I just drove you on the weekend.
Oh,
stop.
The guy who owns Cheers.
Yeah.
Yeah, right on. Okay.
Yeah, you can't put that on there now.
Yeah, I can.
Why? So what's, I don't understand what's the...
Dude, you could have just hopped back in your truck and I wouldn't have even known it was you. Right, now a neighbor, in this area around here has complained that, it smells and there's maggots and it's being stuffed full of garbage.
Yeah, of course there is.
Right, so they're complaining about it.
Yeah.
So I came up here to, document that.
Stuffing a mattress in there.
Yep. And that was that guy that was just right there that
yeah,
I was
this
videoing?
Morning.
And that was just this morning. That
yeah.
was him putting that mattress in there right now.
This morning.
And now it's become interesting because the guys who are supposed to clean it up are here all of a sudden. So it's good timing. It's good timing.
It's like there's nothing to clean up, though.
Well, yeah, it kind of looks like there's a bit to clean up.
Let's go. Yeah, but it's in the garbage can. You got it, Tom? No, I know. Well, you got it, though? Like, it's in the garbage can, right?
So why are you here?
That's what I'm trying to figure out.
Come on, Doug.
You're not sure why you're here?
No, I'm not.
Okay. Now they're leaving, it looks like. It's Avenue Living.
This guy threw his TV at me yesterday from 40 feet away because it was going to hit me on my deck while he was swearing at me because I made him take it off of the ground in the alley. So he picked up his TV, and that's after he threw it at me from the parking lot swearing at me.
Seems like a lot of work.
I know, right?
That's like an 80-pound TV.
Right? To pick it up over your head and try and throw it at me from the parking lot to the deck. I don't think you're going to get me.
So your main concern when you had contacted me is that I guess the garbage is in such close proximity to, I'm guessing, the wood chips, so there's maggots and whatnot?
Like, we had to move our swing set because it's too close to where the garbage comes in the yard.
Yeah. So stuff's blowing out of the top of it, or?
Used feminine hygiene products in my yard in the morning.
This person contacted me about the garbage problem right next to the Avenue Living apartment here, and it's just the day that I released this video about what the health inspector said about sushi and Thai place. So I think somehow now I found this niche where people are going to get me to investigate disgusting stories
with
maggots.
You'll be like the maggot guy.
Yeah, I agree.
now they are calling me in my home residence to come outside and attack me. So two grown men standing there calling me a bitch this morning and all this shit while my children are standing here playing. This gentleman here is in his late 80s and just had triple bypass surgery and spends his mornings cleaning up the garbage.
Oh, they're coming back. They just circled back around. I hope I got the shot there. BS.
It's just gotten to the point of ridiculous. I've made repeated calls to bylaw, which keep promising to fine them for the illegal dumping. This gentleman has made repeated calls to bylaw as well.
Yeah.
I've called the Avenue Living Office in Medicine Hat. I've called the Avenue Living Office in Calgary, and I've spoken with the Avenue Living Office in Edmonton.
What's it like when you call the Avenue Living Office?
Belligerent. You get passed a lot around between like a call center unit, and the second you ask to speak to a manager, you are disconnected.
She showed me a picture of her wall. It was all black from mold.
Yeah.
And they wouldn't do anything about it.
Yeah. Oh, I came up here, and right when I got here, two guys from Avenue Living got out of a truck, and they started saying, F you, get the F out of here.
You were the guy videotaping.
Yeah, I was videotaping them yesterday.
My wife was telling me about it.
So then the neighbors, this person and that person, and there was a person further down the hall, they had contacted me, and they said, you know what? I think we got her solved. The BFI guys showed up. I think they're going to fix it, and they were all happy.
Yeah, right.
And then they contacted me again today, and they said, look at what it looks like now. So I came up to look. You know what that is?
Oh, beautiful.
Yeah. So it's not just trash at this point.
I wonder if I should text Monica that.
Oh, I'm waiting for the police. I called bylaw non-emergency said, I don't have gloves, but somebody's got to come clean this thing up. And on closer inspection, this is definitely a huge problem for kids that are playing outside. I don't have gloves or anything to handle this with, though. There's nothing I can do right now, and it does have the cover on the tip of it there, but this is clearly a hypodermic needle.
What?
Just kind of trying to get the shot for the story, you know.
Like, you want, like, there's needles in there.
Yeah. So about how many do you pick up a day?
It's just hit and miss, but like today, for some reason, there was this one and then two other ones.
So is three a day like a big day for needles found publicly, or?
Yeah.
Yeah?
It's not normally that bad, but...
Can I ask you how you feel about it?
What's this for, first of all?
I run a YouTube channel called Community TV. Yeah. And, like, I was up here just because neighbors contacted me and said, oh, there's a lot of garbage. And I was like, I don't really care about garbage blowing in the wind that much. It's not a story. Yeah. But then I came up here, and the two guys from the management company were, like, swearing at me and, like, wanted to, like, fight because I was videotaping the garbage. And, yeah, I thought that was pretty funny. But then that night, everybody had called, and they said, you know what? The BFI guys are here. They're cleaning it up. It looks like everything's good. And I said, well, why even bother covering that story then? So I just left it. And then they contacted me again today with these pictures. And I said, well, I'll go up there and check it out. And when I got here, I saw that needle.
It was the only monitoring friggin' by the neighbor.
Seagull. The seagull's the only one monitoring this pile right here.
It doesn't stop anybody anyways, unfortunately.